हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम मिस्टर रविंद्र भालेराव एंड आई वेलकम यू टू माय चैनल दैट इज इंग्लिश फॉर लर्नर्स। फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न इंग्लिश वर्कशॉप ऑफ द लेसन मिस स्लीपरी। बट बिफोर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो, एज यूजुअल आई रिक्वेस्ट यू डोंट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल। द नेम ऑफ द टॉपिक इज मिस स्लीपरी। Let's see warming up activities. Number 1. Do you argue with your friends? Why? Answer: Yes, at times I do argue with my friends. This is usually because we have a difference of opinion between us. Also, at times when my friends unnecessarily tease me, I find it unfair. It leads to an argument. Next question. Do you stop your arguments after some times or continue it for a long time? Answer. Our group of friends have been together since childhood. Or since first standard. We have realized that arguments need to be sorted by talking it out. Anger and revenge are not solution to the problem. So, whenever we have an argument, we give each other time to think about it and then discuss it out again. At times, we also decide to let go of the argument, as our friendship means more to us than our differences of opinion. Next question. Why do people quarrel or fight? Answer. People usually quarrel due to differences of opinions. Next question. Do we forgive or punish our dear ones after their mistakes? Answer. Most people punish their dear ones when they commit mistakes. But rather than punishing the dear, it is necessary to understand the reason for the committing the mistake and the conditions under which the person must have committed the mistake. Once our focus shifts from the door to deed, we will be better equipped to handle the mistakes of our dear ones. Next question. What do you feel after a quarrel with the dear ones? Answer. After a quarrel with dear ones, all that remains is unhappiness and uneasiness. Many a times, in the heat of the moment, many things are said which may cause irreparable damage to the relationship. One must realize that physical wounds will heal over time, but wounds caused to one's feelings may never be forgotten. Next question. Rewrite using proper punctuation marks and capital letters. Its sentences as well as answers are given. Please watch on the screen. Next question. Write in your own words. What according to you is the best way to get rid of a negative or bad quality in your friend? Answer. The best way to rid a friend of a bad quality is by talking it out. By talking, showing empathy, and with the right amount of encouragement, we can make him or her realize their faults and rid them of their bad habits. Let's see margin questions of this topic. Question number 1. Why could the notebook have fallen from Siley's hand? Answer. Because when her teacher shouted her and said that to come there with her book, Sally obeyed her. Angry look made her legs tremble. So, the notebooks fell on her feet. Next question. What happened when it was Sally's turn to answer? Answer. When it was Sally's turn to answer, she became blank. The teacher gave her a stern stare while she stood there stiff still with her head hanging down in shame. Next question. What did Sally long for from her mother? Answer. Sally longed that her mother should hold her and console her. She should give her sympathetic pat. Next question. Why did Sally begin crying again? Answer. Sally began crying again because as her mother walked away to the kitchen, her younger brother came and sat beside her. He placed his little hand on her arm and whispered, "Are you in great pain?" Sally became overwhelmed and started crying again. Next question. By what name did the girls tease Sally? Answer. They teased her new title every day. They call her Slippery. Next question. What was Sally told to do by teacher? Answer. Teacher told her to see her in the teacher's room after the class. Next question. What two relationships did the teacher offer her or Sally? Answer. Elder sister and a friend. Next question. Why did Sally feel like rejoicing a lot? Answer. When her teacher, who had spontaneously accepted her as a sister and a friend, Sally felt like rejoicing a lot. Next question. How did Sally react this time to the teasing? Answer. Sally remembered her teacher's word. She turned her back to them and ignored them completely. Next question. What responsibilities did the teacher give Sally? Answer. Sally gave the responsibility of bringing the register, chalk and duster every morning. Let's see English workshop. 1. Two different words are joined to form a new word with a new meaning. Such words are called compound words. For example, homework or kind-hearted. Pick out some compound words from the lesson. Answer. Notebooks. Next, all devouring. Next, well prepared. Next, never ending. Next, sometimes. Next, high pitched. Next, antiseptic. Next, re-entering. Next question, 2A. Add the proper prefix to make the following words opposite in meaning. Words and answer. Obey, disobey. Sympathetic, asympathetic. Honor, dishonor. Afraid, unafraid. Next question, 2B. Add suffix to convert the following words to adjective forms. Laugh, laughable. Thought, thoughtful. Punish, punishable. Forget, forgetful. Care, careful. Count, countable. Fear, fearful. Move, movable. tear, tearful. Joy, joyful. Next question. Find words or expressions from this story which are similar in meaning to. 1. Very expensive. Answer: extravagant. 2. Longing for. Answer: yearning. 3. Could not remember at all. Answer: went blank. 4. Constant. Answer: never ending. 5. Gather all one's courage. Answer: muster courage. 6. Filled and increased in size. Answer: inflate. 7. Painful badly, paining badly. Answer: smarting. 8. Forced to pay a big amount of money. Answer: pay through one's nose. Next question. Answer in short, in your own words. Number 1. The history teacher had asked them to memorize it. What? Answer: teacher had asked them to memorize the causes and effects of the Battle of Panipat. Next question. Sally's new frock tore. How? Answer: one day, Sally was coming down the school stairs. Somebody from the top gave a frantic scream. She fell and came tumbling down about 7 steps, and her new frock was torn at the seams. Next question. Sally hugged him tight. Who? Answer: Sally hugged tightly to her younger brother. Next question. Sally was called slippery. Why? Answer: Sally was called slippery because she used to walk cautiously, yet she would often stumble. Next question. Teacher told Sally to meet her in the teacher's room when? Answer: teacher told Sally to meet her in the teacher's room after the class. Last question. Teacher asked Sally to carry the notebooks where? Answer: teacher asked Sally to carry the notebooks to the teacher's room. Next question. Write what expressions does a person use in the following situations. 1. When a person gets a sudden fright. Answer: oh God, oh dear, oh no. 2. When a person is very nervous. I am afraid that I can't feeling well. What if? 3. When a person is tensed. Answer: I am really worried that. I fear that. I hope that. 4. When a person is very happy. Yippee! Yes! I am so happy. 5. When a person is very confident. I am sure that. I have a feeling that I can do this. 6. When a person is very angry. Answer: that really irritates me. This is very annoying. That ticks me off. Next. When a person is very sad. Answer: I am hurt that. I am sorry. I'm really upset about. Let's see questions related to the language study. 1. Some words in English do not change in a regular pattern when their tense changes. These verbs are called irregular verbs. Fill the form of verbs in the following table. Its answer in table is given. Please watch on the screen. Next question. 3-1. Fill up the table of tenses using the verb give. The answer is given. Please watch on the screen. Next question. Say whether the following sentences are in continuous tense or perfect tense. 1. I was entering the class. Answer: continuous tense. 2. The girls are teasing me. Answer: continuous tense. 3. I haven't said a word to you. Answer: perfect tense. 4. Never before had anyone lavished love on me. Answer: perfect tense. 5. You are going to be responsible for it. Answer: continuous tense. And 6. According to the teacher, I had dropped the notebook on purpose. Answer: perfect tense. Next question. Turn the following sentences into polite requests. For example, show me the way to post office. Answer: would you please show me the way to the post office? 1. Take me to your teacher. Answer: would you mind taking me to your teacher? 2. Tell me something about your school. Answer: do you mind telling me something about your school? 3. Give me the details about your extracurricular activities. Answer: would it be possible to give me the details about your extracurricular activities? 4. Provide me the information about books if your school library. Answer: would you be willing to provide the information about books in your school library? Let's see glossary or difficult words from this text. Please watch on the screen. Friends, I hope you might have liked this video. If you liked it, please share it. If you have any suggestions for me, please write in comment box. Wish you a good day. Thank you very much.